Let's head into our Health Topics Tuesday for this morning, sponsored by Star Valley Health. And Joel Johnson is in studio with me live right now this morning. Good morning, Joel. How are you today?
Good morning, Duke. Thank you for having me in, and happy St. Patrick's Day.
Hey, you too. Neither of us are wearing green. In fact, Dal's not either, so.
Well, I got a green tie on, and I've got some Samrock shocks or socks on, so I'm celebrating a little bit.
All right. Well, I've got leprechaun hair.
There you go.
So it's reddish. So today, we appreciate you coming in this morning. Of course, with coronavirus and everything, Star Valley Health has been taking proactive measures for a long time, and of course, those measures change as corona changes and in our community. So give us some of the latest here.
It really does. I mean, the virus itself and what we know about it and what we're hearing from the Centers of Disease Prevention, the CDC, is changing daily. And so we're trying to keep up with it. We're trying to be preventative and protect our community. As you just mentioned a moment ago, there were 7 more cases reported yesterday in Wyoming and Fremont County. So that puts the state at 10. One of the things we really want to stress to the community is don't panic. Right now, Lincoln County is still considered low risk, but it is coming. I mean, that's just a fact of life. We expect it. You know, we don't have it. We have a crystal ball, but, you know, you don't see a whole lot in there. So we expect it sometime, but we're not sure when. We're kind of guessing maybe after spring break, those that are traveling may bring it back with them.
Well, I'm seeing now that some of the national news is saying that 80% of the virus is spread by people that don't know they have it. That you can be a carrier. And so, I mean, if that's really true, who knows how many's out there? So
very true. And right now in our community, we're seeing a little bit of an upswing in the normal influenza, the flu virus. And so you can carry both of them together. So, you know, again, we're stressing with people, you know, wash your hands, you know, cough into your elbow, wash your hands after you sneeze or blow your nose. If you're feeling ill at all, stay at home. You know, with the coronavirus, been saying it a lot lately and can't get it out. You know, symptoms, the key thing is a fever, specifically 100.4 degrees or higher, coughs, body aches, shortness of breath, and fatigue. If you're having those, we don't want you to just to come to the clinics. We don't want you to just come to the hospital or the ER. Call first and let us know that you're feeling these symptoms, and the care providers will determine where the best place is for you to go to receive the best care. We're just trying to, again, keep you away from as many people as possible, protect our staff and the community as well.
Joel Johnson with our Health Topics Tuesday this morning on Star Valley Health. Joel, I understand that there has been a kind of a hotline implemented for those with questions.
Correct. We do have a hotline set up. It has a recording that we are updating. As we get more information, we're updating that. The hotline number is 307-885-5007. Again, that's 885-5007. We are working on getting a live hotline put together so that people can call and actually talk to a person if they do have questions outside of our normal phone numbers. Again, just trying to be as helpful as possible, and to, again, relieve as much panic and concern as possible with the community members.
Joel, of course, we know about the school closures and event cancellations. The hospital's also put some visitor restrictions in place.
We have. We've actually canceled different events that we have on. Like you just mentioned a little while ago, our auxiliary has canceled their Pizza Hut fundraiser. So through the rest of the month, they will not be at Pizza Hut on Wednesday nights. Our board meeting is canceled. Various classes that we have for the community are canceled. And with our patient restrictions. Right now, most of the people that are being affected by this are the elderly. And so through the CDC and the CMS, they have basically no visitors for the care center. And so we have locked down our care center and have requested no visitors at all. We encourage emails. We also have got it set up to where you can reach out to the care center by phone, and they'd be happy to do a Zoom meeting or a Skype or something like that so that you can see the residents and talk to them that way. Within the hospital itself, the ER, we're really trying to reduce. We don't want anybody in there that's sick unless they're here to get help for themselves, receive care. We're looking at no visitors under the age of 18. We're looking for nobody to really accompany anybody that thinks that they have the COVID-19. Right now, again, we don't have any positives in Lincoln County or in Star Valley. And so if we do, we don't want any visitors for those people that are quarantined as well. So basically, unless you are going to the hospital to receive care for your health, please just stay away. We're looking, starting no later than this upcoming Monday, we're going to be locking down our business services building here in Afton. And so we do have a payment drop box at the hospital. We will have a drop box set up at the BSB themselves, and we will have people on the phone, but we've also started to send people home to work if possible. It's a little hard to do that with the clinical staff. They need to be here to care for the patients. But those that do have some flexibility and we can't allow them to do that from home, again, just keep the social distancing and just trying to keep people as unexposed to this as possible.
You know, Joel, as more information is coming out about this and businesses are taking actions, and the president goes on national stage yesterday and says don't gather in groups of more than 10. The risk here in Lincoln County is still low, and health officials are still saying, you know, use caution, but don't panic. So how serious is it? I know to our local area, I know a lot of residents have questions. Okay, so is it safe for me to go out to eat? I mean, you got to go to the grocery store. I mean, how much caution needs to be taken by the average household if no one in your home seems to be showing symptoms or is sick?
To me, it's in talking with, Dr. Kirk, our chief medical officer, Tori Propes, our vice president of nursing, the meetings that I've been in, the things that we're reading, really it's basic hand hygiene. It's just, if you're ill, don't go out. Call somebody else to go pick up groceries for you. Get some help. I mean, there's plenty of people in the valley that always help out. So that's very easy. Restaurants are closing down. If you watch on the news, restaurants are closing down. You can now do takeout. You can call ahead and pick up takeout, but there's no dine-in. I have a family member that works at Costco. They have removed all of their seating at their basic cafeteria area, so nobody can sit there and have a hot dog. You've got to get it and go. So again, just be conscious. If you're ill, stay at home. Just don't go outside. Wash your hands all the time. Cough and sneeze into your elbow or Kleenex and then wash your hands, hand sanitizer. Go to the grocery, get what you need and leave. You don't have to, they recommend standing and keeping about 6 feet away from each other. So just be cognizant of that. A lot of these things that they're telling us to do are basic things we should do during any flu season. Unfortunately, we're finding out that this virus is a little more susceptible to catch. It's a little more contagious. Again, we're still learning about it. The coronavirus itself has been around for decades, but this new version is, again, something new that we're learning about.
And just to reiterate, again, it's the elderly population that are struggling. So the average person may not even know they have the virus. The symptoms could be so mild, but the reason we have to be extra cautious is because it's really hurting the elderly.
Very true. I mean, we are seeing younger people get it, people in the 30s and 40s as well. But the death toll that we're seeing within the U.S. and across the world is mostly in the elderly, and also those that have some type of comorbidity, asthma, a low immune system, anything like that that you have, you're more susceptible. Anything like that you've got, you need to be, aware of what's going on around you. And again, ask for help. There's plenty of people. I know our local grocery stores, you can call ahead and they'll gather your groceries for you and they'll bring them out to the car. That's a great thing to take advantage of.
Well, Joel Johnson in studio this morning. Thanks so much for the information, Joel. Anything we missed?
No, just again, want to stress to people, prior to coming to the hospital or the clinic, call ahead of time. Watch for that fever of 100.4. We do have the informational hotline again at 885-5007 to help you out. And just, communicate and check on the elderly and just be cognitive of those around you.
Joel Johnson, Health Topics Tuesday this morning, sponsored by Star Valley Health.